Thank you, Congressman, for talking to us. You know, theoretically, this should not be a problem. I mean, it's more of a symbolic move. Jerusalem is indeed the capital of Israel. But obviously, Arab leaders around the world found this to be a big surprise. What message does this send by the president moving the U.S. embassy to West Jerusalem?
It sends the same message that the president has been sending since the moment he took office, that the promises that he makes, he is going to keep. And that's the kind of person that he is. This is a day of celebration for those that are saying this is going to cause unrest. You talk about groups like Hamas out there calling for a day of rage. It shows exactly who any Bloods would be on the hands of. It's those that would go out there and ultimately bring about violence and not anybody else to blame. They're constantly looking for a reason to go out there and cause disruption. And it's not a surprise they'd try to use this like any other reason.
Yeah, and whether this happened or not, the violence would continue. The backlash has been fierce. Intense opposition from leaders around the world with warnings from some Arab countries. And the terror group Hamas has even called for a day of rage, they're calling it. How does the administration plan to deal with the backlash?
You know, this is something that we all have to be aware of, that there's constantly this threat. But if you look, historically speaking, at what's gone on with the existence of government in Jerusalem as we speak, the Knesset, being there since the mid-1960s, there being zero attacks on the Knesset to date, the fact that our diplomats have to travel from Tel Aviv way into Jerusalem, stay in hotels and other things like that where they don't have the same safety of an embassy. This is a common sense move for the safety of the diplomats of the United States of America. And I think beyond that, it goes to this point that we should always remember. You know, we don't make peace with enemies. We make peace and negotiate peace with former enemies. And when you hear them talking about days of rage, that shows you exactly the fact that they are not former enemies. They're still out there looking to combat us.
This clearly draws the line in the sand on the U.S.'s stance on the Israeli-Palestinian conflict, but the decision has reportedly taken Arab leaders not only by surprise, but they feel that, you know, the president possibly should be consulting with Arab officials, perhaps to minimize the backlash in order to keep Palestinian officials willing to negotiate. What do you think of that?
You know, if you ask me, I think they're doing what's expected from them. You know, the leader of Turkey, the leaders of Saudi Arabia, the leaders of Jordan and other places, they're expected to go out there and show some outrage. So let's not be naive about saying that there's politics involved in this. So they're doing what's expected of them. I think in the end, they're probably thankful that the leader of the free world, the United States of America, is going out there and recognizing the capital of freedom throughout the Middle East, and that's the capital of Israel.
All right, Congressman Brian Mast, thank you very much.